Hello everyone. As committed in the last lecture, we will sum up all the techniques that we have discussed till now so that we have a clear picture of what we are doing and in what cases. So to start with, let's first take the case where both the numbers are less than 100. So here, both the numbers are less than 100. That means I have 89 and 96. So both the numbers are less than 100 here. So 89 is 11 less than 100 and 96 is 4 less than 100. Then multiplying 11 and 4 gives me 44, and I do a cross subtraction, either 89 minus 4 or 96 minus 11. Whatever I do, I get 85. So my answer is 8544. So here both the numbers are less than 100. Now let's consider the case where both the numbers are more than 100. For example, 112, that is 112, and 106. In this case, 112 is 12 more and 106 is 6 more. So it's the same thing again. We are just multiplying the right hand side, that is 12 into 6, that gives 72. And then we do a cross addition here, that is 112 plus 6 or 106 plus 12. Whatever we do, we get 118. So the answer is 11872. So I think these things are quite clear for the people. Now let's check out the next cases. So the next case is one number is less than 100 and other number is more than 100. That means one number is less than the base and other number is more than the base. So the first thing is 87, which is less than 100, and 107, which is more than 100. So 87 is 13 less than 100 and 107 is 7 more than 100. Again, the first step goes like this. I multiply 13 into 7, which gives me 91, and either I do 87 plus 7 or 107 minus 13. Whatever I do in the crosswise direction, I get 94. Now, since this is a case where one is more and one is less, what you will do is we will subtract 1 from here and find out complement of 91, that is how less 91 is than 100, than the base. That is, it is 9 less than 100. So I can write here 0, 9, because I want always two numbers. So 94 minus 1, which gives me 93. So the answer is 9309. This is the third case. Let's see the next case. The next cases are like when we multiply the right hand side number, if they are not exactly two digits, either they are more than two digits or they are less than two digits, then what will happen? Let's take a case of 52 and 96. So 52 is how much less than 100? It is 48 less than 100, and 96 is 4 less than 100. So if I multiply the right side, which is 48 into 4, 4 8s are 32, 2 here, 3 carat, 4 4s are 16, plus 3, that is 19. So we are getting actually 192. And on the other side, we get either 52 minus 4 or 96 minus 48. Please do not do 96 minus 48 because you know the result will be same, but it will take little more time. So 52 minus 4 gives 48. So what we should do here is, since 1 is more here, I am taking out 1 as carry forward here to add. So the answer goes like this. 4992 is the answer. And here comes the last case where when we multiply the right hand side numbers, it is becoming less than two digits. For example, I will take a case of 104 and 102. So this is 4 more and this is 2 more. Again, the same principle applies here. We have to multiply the right hand side, that is 4 into 2, that gives me 8. But here we'll write 08 because our base is 100 and 1 has 2 zeros. That means on the right side, I always want 2 digits. If it is less than 2 digits, put a 0 on the left side. If it is more than 2 digits, then take a carry forward the leftmost number. That whatever you have done in the last. Now, to the left side, either I do 104 plus 2 or 102 plus 4. Whatever I do, I get 106. So the answer is 10608. You can cross check all the multiplication that we have done as part of this using the calculator. I hope now the things are quite clear, that whatever we have discussed till now. So the next section we will discuss how this is being done. What is the technique behind it? What is the logic behind it? How these things works?